Right now at 10 o'clock, a man hit and killed while walking along a Rockingham County road. Tonight, investigators are looking for the woman who was behind the wheel. Good evening and thanks for being with us. It happened around 8 o'clock last night on Highway 150, just outside of Reidsville.
Juan Vega was 33 years old, and the Highway Patrol tells Fox 8 he died at the scene. Now the big question tonight, who did it? Our Katie Nordine is live from Rockingham County. And Katie, what exactly do we know?
Well, investigators say when this happened, Vega had been walking from a friend's house and wasn't even a half mile from home. Now, by the time state troopers got there, not even 10 minutes later, they say Vega was already dead and the person responsible was long gone.
With little evidence found at the crash site, investigators with the State Highway Patrol out of Reidsville need your help. Sergeant Sam Wagner says they're looking for the person who struck and killed this man and then drove away.
That's a callous act.
Troopers say Juan Vega was walking home along Highway 150 from a neighbor's house Saturday night, but never made it.
One guy who actually heard it actually came outside, saw the car stop in the roadway, saw the female exit the vehicle, made the statement, "Oh my God," and jumped back in the car and took off.
By the time troopers got to the scene near Northfolk Drive, Vega was already dead. He was about 2 feet into the roadway and was walking with his back towards traffic, which is against state law. Investigators say it was dark outside and Vega was wearing dark colored clothes.
Bar visibility, you probably wouldn't have noticed until you got right up on him. But still, you know, you hit someone or hit something, the first notion is to stop, check and see what it is, and contact the authorities.
Based on limited evidence found at the scene, Sergeant Wagner says they're looking for a light-colored passenger car, possibly even silver. He says there will be some noticeable damage to the front right side of the car.
Now, the state patrol says that once the driver is found, it's likely she will face felony charges. Obviously, they say that is much more severe than if she would have just stayed at the crash site. Now, once again, if you have any information, you are asked to contact the State Highway Patrol. We are live in Rockingham County. Katie Nordine, Fox 8 News.
All right, Katie, thank you.